With me on the line now is Nick Stevens from Stone Checker. Nick, good afternoon.
Yeah, hi Andrew.
Nick, the analysis of two studies carried out for Stone Checker have been completed ahead of schedule. You must be pleased with that.
Yeah, we're absolutely delighted to have finished the two studies early. So, at the moment we couldn't be more pleased.
Well, in terms of the studies themselves, Nick, tell me about what you were looking at, what was involved here.
Okay. So, we're looking at the various factors that lead to the successful treatment of kidney stones. So, the first treatment a patient gets if the kidney stone doesn't pass naturally is a lithotripsy, which is an ultrasound treatment. The sound waves go from outside of the body, hit the stone and crack the stone into small pieces, a little bit like sound waves can break a glass. Unfortunately, the stone doesn't always break, and as many as 40% of patients get repeated lithotripsy treatments over a period of a few days whilst they're in terrible pain, but for the treatments to be unsuccessful. So our two studies were looking at lithotripsy treatment in two countries, the UK and China, and looking at the various factors that might contribute to why the stone doesn't break. And in both countries, we explored different variables, including, most importantly, whether or not our software could predict in advance which patient stones wouldn't break. And the very good news for us is that in both countries, our software became one of the most important variables in predicting whether or not the stone would break. And we had a predictive value of around 71% in both the UK and China. So the reason we're so happy about that is because it proves that there's nothing about the various components in different countries of the treatment process that would mean that our software doesn't work. So that's why we're so pleased with the results. Of course, finishing early also means that we've managed to retain some additional resources, which can be spent further down the road. So altogether, a good day for Stone Checker.
Because initially you were looking at 607 patients, weren't you? The plan was to extend that to 800, but because of the quality of this data, that's obviously now no longer required.
That's right. So the statisticians give us advice on the numbers of patients that we need to be able to get a statistically accurate number. We were really very pleased to discover that at the number that we have enough patients to prove that our software is predicting and not just a random result. It means we just need to look at fewer patient records than we thought we would need to.
And as far as the software is concerned, Nick, you've now teamed up with a company in North America, have you, to develop it further?
Yeah, that's right. So the actual the building of the software is being done by a company in North America, and we've agreed the contract and the timelines and the project's underway. So that's the visual presentation of what is the Stone Checker algorithm, which is the kind of secret medicine inside the software.
And they'll be undertaking the regulatory work to attain the CE mark as well, will they?
They'll do both CE and FDA. So the CE mark, we're extremely confident that that will be a very rapid and simple process and finished by December. The FDA is always more variable, but as a Class 1 medical device, there isn't a diagnostic. So it's really just giving doctors advice on whether or not one treatment is better than another, rather than whether to treat the patient or not.
Right.
So the burden of evidence required is not so great. So we're very confident that we'll get FDA approval as well.
Nick, just while I've got you, I know work's also progressing on Stone Prevent. The name's a bit of a giveaway, but give me a quick reminder on what this product is.
So this is a product which makes Stone Checker, the company, unique in that we're involved not just in the acute treatment of kidney stones, but also in the prevention of kidney stones. So we're involved in the disease from start to finish. One of the incredible things about kidney stones is the pain. So many people who have had kidney stones, and of course women, can tell us that the pain is equivalent to childbirth. So it's a really underreported acute disease. But the most underreported fact is that 50% of patients who have kidney stones have previously had kidney stones. So the American Urology Association has asked all urologists in the USA to engage in prevention behavior, so prevention of kidney stones. And what we're doing at Stone with our Stone Prevent product is trying to pull that together to make all that prevention activity very streamlined and simple. So the prevention involves blood tests, urine tests, and analysis of patients' diet and lifestyle. Now, that's quite time-consuming for a surgeon who treats patients' acute kidney stone. So it really doesn't happen very often. And in the UK, there are only a very small number of clinics that offer a prevention service for kidney stones. Around different parts of the world, it happens to a greater or lesser extent than in the UK. But nowhere is it offered routinely. And the reason for that is that it's complicated. You have to pull together blood results, urine results, the patient's diet and lifestyle. So what we're doing is creating an automated report that will bring all of the variables, including our Stone Checker score, together. And then through the automation of the report, the patient and the doctor will get lifestyle advice and a diagnosis of the type of kidney stone that they have and why it recurs. Now, there's what we call level one evidence, which is the highest level of evidence that prevention does work if it's done correctly. So we're super optimistic that we'll be able to sell our products to patients, to doctors, and most importantly, to the payers for healthcare. That's one of the things we're most excited about with our two products, is that no one loses out from using our products. Mm-hmm. Everyone gets the benefit. The surgeons get to make more accurate lithotripsy and have a higher success rate. The patients are saved the inconvenience and the pain of kidney stones. And we think perhaps of equal importance is the fact that we're going to save a lot of healthcare resources in unnecessary failed lithotripsy and in recurrent kidney stones that can be prevented. So we feel we're going to be pretty popular with the healthcare payers.
Pretty popular and super excited, as you say, Nick. Just what's the next steps towards commercialization here for Stone Prevent?
Okay, so Stone Prevent, we have a pilot of the product, which is currently being developed with a university in the UK. And this will be the report automation. And so when we have the report automation, we then start building out the commercial distribution network. We've already solved the problem with the laboratories and logistics. So we have had successful talks with a UK pathology laboratory service, which will actually do the test for us. So our path is to pull all of this together and make it streamlined and be a kind of one place for the doctors to send patient data. And then in September, we attend a UK urology conference where we present the results of our work and get some early feedback on the algorithm, the automated report system that we've produced. So really, the Stone Prevent is in a kind of mid-phase product development.
That's great, Nick. Sounds like things are coming along nicely for you. Look, a busy couple of months ahead. Great to speak to you.
Okay, thank you very much.